Then now, so as you can see, this is the base voltage. This is the base voltage of this transistor, and the collector current IC1 is in this direction here. It is in this direction here. Okay. So now let us do the mathematical part. VB1 is equal to, what is VB1? VB1 is this voltage. Where is this voltage? Between the base emitter voltage. That can be written as equal to VM1 plus VC. Where am I getting this? VM1, okay, plus VC. This voltage VBE is equal to VM and this IC. Isn't it? This voltage between these two points is coming from VM plus VC. So instead of just writing VM, VM is now divided into, that is the modulating signal voltage is divided into VM1 and VM2, two transistors. So you are writing it as VM1, VC is common. And you know how to write this VM1 as AM cos omega MT and VC is AC cos omega CT. So here these two are instantaneous values. These two are instantaneous values. So we are writing VB1 like this, and VB2 will be modulating signal plus, it's nothing but we are adding modulating signal half here and half here. So as I told you, this is because of the center tap, because of the center tapping transistor, center tap transformer. You are able to write this as plus Vm and that is equal to minus Vm. So when you have a center tap here, this voltage is plus Vm here and this is minus Vm. So using the same principle, I am writing this like this. So VM1 plus VCT is AM cos omega MT plus from AC cos omega CT. And for the second transistor, it is minus VM1, which is minus AM cos omega MT plus AC cos omega CT. So now, by using, how am I writing the collector current? By using the formula and the principle of, what is the principle that you are using? Square law. By using square law property, I am writing IC1 is equal to A1, A2, which are constants to be evaluated. You can write it as A1, A2, or you can write it as A plus B. If I write A plus B, you should write A1 plus B1 and A2 plus B2. Different textbooks use different notation. It doesn't matter, they are only constants. So IC1 is A1 BB1 plus A2 BB1 square. And similarly, IC2 can be written as A1 VB2 plus A2 VB2 square. The IC1, IC2 are given by this expression. Substitute the equation 1 and equation 2 in equation 3. What do you get? A1. What is VB1? Minus AM cos omega MT plus cos omega CT plus A2 VB1 square, the square of this. Similarly, IC2 is given by these expressions. Copy down this. I'm just substituting 1 and 2 equations into equation 3. What you get is this.